The purpose of the Georgia Total Learning Architecture demonstration is to show how a statewide open ecosystem built on technical standards can enable a blend of traditional, virtual, and personalized competency-based learning. Hi, I'm Caitlin McMahon-Dooley, Deputy Superintendent for Teaching and Learning at the Georgia Department of Education. We've been working hard to transform the Georgia Department of Education into an agency dedicated to helping our school districts serve the whole child. This summer, Georgia embarked on a bold new approach, leveraging an open learning architecture conceptualized by the Department of Defense Advanced Learning Research Group, ADL. This total learning architecture is an evolving set of standardized web services to facilitate responsible sharing of essential learning processes and progress data between applications.
Hello, I'm Dr. Keith Osborne, Associate Superintendent for Georgia Virtual Learning. This innovation is being led by Georgia Virtual Learning, which operates the Georgia Virtual School. Georgia Department of Education's Georgia Virtual is a SACS-CASI accredited institution and operates in partnership with schools and parents to offer middle and high school level courses across the state. Georgia Virtual provides a teacher-led, virtual classroom environment and has over 100 course offerings in the core content areas as well as world languages, CTAE, electives, and a vast AP course selection. This state-developed curriculum is made available outside of the virtual classroom as open educational resources for use in local programs or for personalized learning and independent study. Georgia Virtual's TLA vision is not just a system or a platform. While it does provide secure access to online courses and operates as a supplemental school, it's also an architecture for an open ecosystem providing core services such as a single sign-on to learning management, online tools, and secure teacher access to student records, learning standard services to enable common alignment of assessment and instruction around student expectations, an open access library of high-quality learning resources which can be easily searched to discover and select the most effective content for each student or group of students, learning management for course delivery, and a learning record store containing records of student learning experiences, work, and activities as evidence of mastery expressed as competency assertions and awarded badges. We're going to build on our successes at Georgia Virtual Learning and pilot a focused implementation of the Total Learning Architecture vision. We're using computer science to build the initial proof of concept and already have most of the pieces in place. The challenge is coordinating the sharing of learning experiences and progress data across systems and institutions securely and in a consistent form. We decided to start with computer science because there's a growing recognition of its importance in preparing the next generation of Georgia learners. Additionally, there's an openness to new teaching and learning models and tools in the domain. There are nearly 10 times as many computer science jobs as there are qualified applicants to fill them. Additionally, minority and female students are underrepresented and missing some of the best opportunities for upward mobility. The approach is to provide learners with a range of learning experiences in the classroom, after school, and for self-directed learning, all aligned to computer science skills and learning pathways. While we are starting with computer science, we intend this work to extend to all subjects over time. We set a few initial goals. First, to create new types of embedded assessments that go beyond state summative assessments. Instead, now choosing to focus on timely feedback of progress and asserting the whole learner. Also, we set a goal to enable transferability of competency assertions in an open ecosystem to support any time, any place, any pace learning in school, out of school, and online. We believe that the component technology services we are putting in place are indispensable to enable schools to transform to enable personalized, competency-based learning. The starting point for this change is a new technical specification from IMS Global called CASE, the Competency and Academic Standards Exchange. Georgia is the first state to use this standard to publish our Georgia Standards of Excellence in this new format. Until now, Georgia, like most other states, published our academic standards in PDF form. While this was okay for humans to read, the standards typically needed to be retyped or imported into each digital resource, learning tool, and environment independently, often with incompatible formats. To solve that problem, Now, we are using an open source case tool called OpenSol to publish our Georgia Standards of Excellence in machine-readable form with unique reference identifiers that can be managed and automatically updated, assuring everyone uses the same and current references. This is actually one of the most costly and vexing challenges for districts looking to transition to digital materials and assessment tools. In support of our proof of concept, Georgia is developing a set of pathways for computer science and computational thinking. This is done in Public Consulting Group's OpenSol application, incorporating explicit crosswalks aligning our standards to both the National Computer Science Teacher Association framework and local district and program-specific standards. That way, resources aligned at the national and state level can be discovered and assigned using each district's locally managed learning targets. Once the learning standards are published as data, the curriculum team at Georgia Virtual uses an open source content management tool to select and align high quality learning content to the standards of excellence for computer sciences and organize them into reusable units and modules. With the content organized and tagged with the Georgia Standards of Excellence, any educator, student, or system can discover this content and include it in course sequences or as part of personalized playlists. This is exactly what we are doing for this pilot in Georgia Virtual. Georgia Virtual course developers use the D2L Learning Management System's LTI tool to select the appropriate units and modules from the statewide CMS, acting as the tool provider. Developers can search or browse the CMS for aligned and vetted parts, or simply select and use the organized units and modules within their LMS to assemble the course content and sequence it as a complete program. The process results in a course populated with content aligned to the most current state and district standards, which can be centrally updated and managed, but used across all the districts in the state. The next step in the course creation process is to set up the assessment elements of the course instance. This is done within the LMS directly by adding gradable assignments. One of the activities included in our example CS course is a culminating project that is part of a code.org lesson. The link to that interactive lesson is included as a performance task assessment of the student's ability to decompose problems into smaller components through systematic analysis using constructs such as procedures, modules, and/or objects. This is one of the CS competencies in the case framework, and the teacher must create an evaluation rubric for the student's work on this coding challenge to determine how well she mastered that competency, what is termed the competency level. This is done in the D2L assessment module by crafting a new or using an existing rubric, the same rubric that can be included in the case computer science framework itself. Now that the course and these assessment elements are complete, students are able to take the course. Georgia's next generation of learners can assess learning resources in both personalized pathways and through group managed courses. For example, within the Introduction to Computer Science course, there are rich, interactive activities available at code.org. The Georgia course uses select activities of the full code.org course. Through the CMS LTI linking, either a whole code.org course or a smaller course component, such as a specific culminating activity, can be included within the Georgia Virtual course sequence. Students are instructed to take a screenshot when they complete their code.org activity and submit it to their teacher through automated Dropbox integration using a simple I Did It Chrome extension or a handy mobile app to capture evidence of learning. Similarly, students might take a picture of their toothpick bridge physics project or music performance for evaluation by the teacher. These new Georgia tools make it easy for students and teachers to capture learning activities, assigned or not, formal or informal. The learning activities become part of their learning record store and trigger teacher evaluations of that student work. Student activities that are graded assignments and culminating activities are evaluated by the teacher or a system using a competency rubric that is constructed as part of the course assessment plan. The teacher's evaluation produces a record we are calling a competency assertion. These assertions can be stored in the LRS and awarded as an automated badge to the student using the Open Badges Standard, or OBI. The portable badge contains a link to the Mastered Competency in GeorgiaStandards.org and a secure access link to the student's work as evidence of their level of mastery. It's also another gate along the career learning pathway. These awarded badges are presented to learners as a step along a pathway to some larger career goal, such as a college degree, the military, or even an entry point to one's career. Once attained, badges open gateways to new and progressively more rigorous learning opportunities. In more traditional settings, students often achieve passing grades for credit without mastering the full set of competencies targeted by the class. As a result, by the time they graduate high school and attempt to make the transition to college, military, or workforce, many have huge gaps in their learning. Colleges are forced to remediate these gaps by requiring students to take full courses without course credit towards their post-secondary degree to ensure that these gaps are filled. This is among the barriers that result in less than half of students who enroll in state and community colleges completing their degrees, and one of the driving forces for this proof of concept. Learning pathways are not the only benefit of this architecture. The learning record store captures all student activities and outcomes in real time. With these data, we are able to identify trends and patterns in learning behavior and academic performance, used then to effectively alert instructors and administrators, targeting academic interventions when and where they're most needed. These data enable the creation of predictive models based on the alignment of educational activity and learning outcomes, and provide the big data set needed to drive insights and leverage developments in student-centered learning.
Hello, my name is Richard Woods, State School Superintendent of Georgia. How can you help? Your partnership allows us to explore and realize this vision. Georgia Virtual Learning is committed to leading the way in building the future of personalized, competency-based education. The experience gained through this initial Total Learning Architecture, or TLA, computer science proof of concept will be leveraged to a full-scale pilot quickly. While starting with CS, we will take what we learn and apply it to other subjects and career pathways progressively.